הברכה says, כיוון פשוט המנהג בכל המקומות לתת על ספר תורה פעמונים, המשמיעים קול, ואין בזה איסור שמשמיע קול בשבת. Even though we said one cannot do any kind of music and any instrument is forbidden, however the rimonim, that are on top of the sefer Torah, not a problem, even though they might make noise and have sometimes bells inside of the rimon in order to make sound, that's mutar, because again, this is not made for song, it's not made for shir, but rather again, it's for the hamunam, and it's also to decorate the sefer Torah. Parochet shetilim ba'pa'amonim, ha'mashmirim kol ha'mazazat ha'parochet. On the bottom of the parochet, sometimes they have little bells that are hanging. So he says, "En tzorich lehasiram me'erev Shabbat." One does not have to remove those bells from Friday before Shabbat. She'arei pa'amonim elu asuyim le'tzorich mitzvah. Again, these bells were put in for tzorich mitzvah. Lehodia la'am ha'petichat ha'echav ve'eno kol shashir. They will put, so this way people should hear the sefer Torah is opening. People start hearing the bells, they know that means the heichal is opening. So this way they pay attention. So again, since again this wasn't put in for the sake of shir, so even though regular bells that are made for music or to bang, to make some kind of sound is forbidden, but these bells which are made for the sefer Torah, for the heichal, that are made for the people to know that the sefer Torah is open, it's out, taking out the sefer Torah, one would be allowed to carry the sefer, open the heichal, and it's not a problem of hashma'at kol whatsoever.